Absolutely nothing is going to change on this channel. I'm going to post the exact same types of videos in 2025. That's all. Just kidding. Actually, there are a few things that are going to change. I just got a bit tired of all those YouTubers posting videos about how everything is going to change in 2025. And then you watch those videos, then you realize, not that much. I wanted to post this video to kind of reflect a bit about last year. It's not been an easy year for us. I did learn a very important lesson, and that actually also applies to software design and life in general. And then I'm going to talk quickly about what you can expect on this channel this coming year. As I was thinking about the YouTube channel and everything that happened in the past year, I realized I've been doing this for 4 years already, which is completely insane. Time really flies. If you've been one of the first subscribers, thank you for sticking around so long. A lot happened last year internally at ArjanCodes. It was actually pretty chaotic. We started the year very strong by launching a new course, the Software Architect Mindset. We did that in January. Lots of people enjoyed the course. If you want to learn more about that, by the way, check it out on my website. And then, things kind of went downhill. What I wanted to do in the beginning of last year is post more content. You know, I thought, hey, this thing is working. Let's just post more. So then I posted a second video a week for a while. It's called that Tuesday Tips, which was like a short video explaining like a very specific thing. But we soon learned that that was actually not working well at all. Actually, what happened was that the number of views didn't really increase. So basically, instead of everybody watching that one Friday video, people were kind of split. Some people were watching the Tuesday Tips and other people were watching the Friday video. So the views didn't increase. And at the same time, the watch time on YouTube went down because we posted shorter videos. And that had an unfortunate effect on the channel in general, because if the watch time goes down, YouTube algorithm thinks that your content is not as good. So then it's going to push things out less, which leads to less views. And then everything basically just went off a cliff on the channel. And that was a really frustrating thing to learn. Another problem that we encountered was more like a personal issue with me, in that I always want to do way too many things. I've like always tons of crazy ideas, and then I get all excited about those ideas and I want to basically do them immediately, not really thinking about the consequences. Now, when you're just working on your own, you know, you can have like a ton of crazy ideas and you just do whatever, and you are the one who has to deal with the consequence of that. But if you have a team, things really change, because then you can't do those things anymore, because your team is going to be completely confused. And that's kind of what happened a little bit in the past year. So for me, that was definitely a big lesson to learn. Now, the other side of that is that sometimes it's actually nice to have crazy ideas, because, you know, those ideas can lead to great results. Without me having crazy ideas, I wouldn't have launched the ArjanCodes channel, for example. So it's really a balance that you have to maintain between keeping things stable and simple and sometimes doing some crazy things. But last year, I kind of went a bit overboard with that. You know, I launched an AI platform. I did more content. I hired more people. And as a result, the costs of the company increased, because ArjanCodes is a company. We had diluted focus because of that, because there were way too many things going on at the same time. And that also meant that I had trouble keeping up the quality of the content, because I couldn't spend all the time I wanted on great content. So as a result, views drop, everything drops basically. So last year in May, we kind of took a drastic action. We basically stopped doing a lot of things that didn't work. We stopped lots of fun side project that didn't really bring any value. Also scaled down the team a bit to reduce cost. It's really so stupid. It seems like every business owner makes these mistakes, but it's really hard to detect these things when you're really in the thick of things. But currently, I'm pretty happy with where we're at. We're a smaller team now. Our cost is a bit lower. There's less management work for me, so that means that I have more time to spend on the videos and the scripts and everything surrounding the content, which is what this is all about. Also, we try to organize ourselves a little bit better in terms of measuring what we do and trying to improve those things. So we basically now track a number of key metrics that basically give us an indication of the health of the company. It's like 10, 15 numbers. And then in each area, you can dive deeper and you can track more things. But there's basically about 10, 15 numbers that are important for the business as a whole. So these are things like, how many courses did we sell? What's the click-through rate on YouTube? What's the average view duration on YouTube? How many subscribers did we gain, etc.? These kind of things. So we track these metrics very low-key in an old-fashioned Excel sheet. And then we define OKRs, objectives and key results, every quarter for us to improve those numbers. For example, one quarter we might focus on improving the click-through rate by doing more tests with thumbnails and titles on YouTube. Or another quarter, we might focus on the average view duration by working on the quality of the script. And by focusing on these key metrics and defining OKRs, it all sounds very businessy and boring, right? But it really has helped me a lot to avoid basically the shiny object syndrome that I was dealing with in the beginning of the year. So at the moment, we just do a few things, but we try to do them well. At least that's the intention. And what I've noticed is that this actually has calmed down things in the company a lot. It has removed a lot of stress from everybody in the team. I feel like the videos have become better because we're doing less things, but we focus more on the quality of the script, the storytelling, the, you know, everything surrounding making good videos. Now, I'm not saying I'm a great video producer or something. I mean, in the end, I'm making tutorial videos, so I don't need things to be fancy, but I do feel much happier with the quality of the videos in the past 2 months versus in the beginning of the year. And it also means that I feel more at ease now and I don't worry so much about everything. So what is going to happen with the ArjanCodes channel in 2025? Well, basically I'm following the keep things stupidly simple principle this year, like in software design. Honestly, I think this principle supersedes anything. If there's one thing you do in how you organize yourself, in your software design, in your life in general, it's to always try to keep things simple. For me, that's an important lesson to learn. I have to always remind myself of that. Now, that doesn't mean we're not going to do anything this year. Actually, we are going to do quite a few things. One is that, and that's something that you're going to notice in a few months, which is that we are going to move to another office. Something a little bit smaller. And I also want to move to a more central location, which is closer to a train station, because most of the team is, well, not based in this area. So they have to travel to get here. So I want to make that a bit easier for everybody. And it's also fun to be in a city. And now we're kind of in the middle of nowhere and there's not really much to do here.
One thing you need to do when you move to a new place is that you actually also need to clean up the old place. And the problem is I put this acoustic treatment on the walls basically everywhere. And that means I now need to clean up a bunch of glue residue. You can actually see that right here. So I'm afraid that's going to be me and a spatula like this and a lot of time.
Now, second thing that we're going to do is we're working on something really cool for companies specifically. I can't share yet with you what that is, but that's coming soon. If you want to be kept updated about it, as well as other news about Python software development, make sure to subscribe to my newsletter. Link is down below. Anyway, I hope you have a great 2025. What are your plans? What are you excited to learn more about? What videos would you like me to do? Let me know in the comments below. Now, one thing that I highly recommend you do is get more practice and dive in deep. Read and refactor code. My last code roast video is a great way to start. So in this video, I do a code review of a project and then refactor that code to improve the design. You can check it out right here. Thanks for watching and see you next time.